Hello, I'm Vincent Lamay from Belgium. I'm here because I've been asked to judge the next Wildman Spring Games in April. So I've been there twice. It's one of the best events I've never been. It's a good, very good atmosphere. Everybody's helping each other. Yeah, today I'm here to demonstrate the shoes you will have to make during this competition in the open classes. So here we have my prepared shoe. It's a cap to hind with straight barlet. It's made out of 30 by 8 by 35 centimeters. So I mark it as a left shoe as it is a left shoe. So I offset the center dot of 2 millimeters to the inside, just to be able to stretch a little bit more the inside branch. And then from this point, I take 4 centimeters on each side to make the cap too.
And yes.
So to make that shoe, I didn't bump the two. I just stretch out the branches, keeping a bit of material for the half bars. So I begin with putting the corner of the anvil in the stock bar. But you just have to try not to go too deep in it. Otherwise you will get big marks in the corners of the cap too. So as I said before, I set down the material for the cap 2 here. Not going too deep in the section. So I stretch out the first time, keeping a bit more of material to make the bar here. Flat out. So now in the next heat, I'm gonna bend and make the half bar before I measure from here the corner to the corner of the bar. And then you stretch to the proper size. So now we make the half bar here. Just take care to bend it to the good side, not the other one. So here from the corner of the cap up to the corner of the bar you need 125, something around this. When you bend it you get about the size that you just get a bit of material to stretch when you're furling it. So here I only had 5 millimeters to stretch out more, so it's more like cleaning edges than really stretching, otherwise you're too long. About to be good. So now I just clean a little bit the cap too, going here on the edge. So you make a nicer corner here. I get my 125, so let's go. Let's go for the other side. So the next step is to bend the cap too. And just take it just the same as it, if it was a clip. Put it on the edge. Just like a mascot clip. Just a huge one. And that's it. So I bend it the first time like this, keeping all the time the section straight and as level as possible. Then I leave it a little bit open. I don't put it square directly. But we will see this. Here on the edge, try to make a line with all the section and the edge of the anvil. Just make the two corners first to define where it has to be. And then the middle. Don't go too far the first time, you have to level everything. Always keep the control of the section. So now it's basically drawn. So the next step is to put it in the section. I go with my hammer with this, about this angle. So if you go like this, you will just roll it on the section and it won't go in the base of it. So I always keep an angle to put it in. So now we put it in the section, as we said before, with the angle in the armor. Don't have to hit too hard, it's not necessary. It's more pushing the material in than anything else. So keeping it open, you still have access also with your hammer behind it. What you want is something clean here. Nice section all the way. Just also have to finish to clean this part here. Just like when you were putting it. Also always remember to keep it quite strong. There's no point to get it like a sheet. So. So now we're gonna bend the two. You see, I try to hit it really slowly and not too hard. Now you can see it's bending already, so that's why I'm losing the block. And you continue the same process. This is why the block is used for, so you get a very better, easiest level of the shoe. Otherwise, you always have to work here with your hammer, and you get some problems. So here I shaped the branch, begin with the outside. Carve this part. I just try to check that the bar is about the middle of the two, so I have to close everything a bit. I try to always keep the block in the anvil, so at any time I can go back on the two to level it. So at this point I like to take a small hit to put everything in place and flex the bar. C'est vrai qu'on dit ça fait des lus, donc... I always like to put a little bit of flux between the two scarves here. And I close them. Just make two hits on the shoe to keep them really tight. And finish to flux overall. when I'm welding, when I take it out of the fire, I like to make two hammer blows just flat on it, just to glue the flux that I put between the scarves. So normally it sticks a bit better together, and then I go down on the scarves on each side. I will finish to brush reflux again and finish the welding. Reshape the bar. Now that the bar is done and welded, I just take a small heat to shape and mark the full rings. So to mark your furrowing, you just have to, I like to put it with the cap tool against the edge, because the furrowing is starting on the same point at the end of the cap tool. Thank you. this step, when you mark your follow ring, you have to keep really relaxed, put everything right in place. This, the nail hole placement is something so important on the whole shoe, you have to be quiet. So before welding, I compensate a bit the material moving when I'm furrowing. When we have compensated before, you don't have a lot of material to draw in after your furrowing. I just clean the edges, go again with the fuller and make the nail holes. You're pretty sure the two furs you can go on the top of the hole of the anvil, so I prefer to stay here on the corner, just hit a little bit before, put it in the air to pretty sure it out. Just a wire brush, flat it out. Normally you get something that looks already a bit finished. Now before the final heat, finish the shaping or the size or the width, or I just measure it. I just need it to get 2 mils of width and that's it. I always try, it's a hot rasp finish shoe, I always try to get the shoe a little bit bigger when you rasp it a bit from everywhere, otherwise you're too small when you finish your rasping. also I can bend a little bit the tool cap to get it a bit more angle in it. Basically, you have the shoe and the technique to make it. Just have to finish a clean rasping. So it's about it. Thank you, guys.